for tuning in to another digital music class with me, Mr. Houchin. I'm really glad you're here. Let's start off by saying hello to all of our friends who are doing this music class in their homes as well, too. Hopefully we can see them sometime soon. Hello, friends. Hello, friends. Hello, friends. And welcome to Music Today. All right, and how about hello to our families who we love and adore and we're spending so much time with. Hello, families. Hello, families. Hello, families. And welcome to Music Today. And hello to Mr. Houchin, pretty please. Hello, Mr. Houchin. Hello, Mr. Houchin. Hello, Mr. Houchin. And welcome to Music Today. And one more time, hello, everybody. Hello, everyone. Hello, everyone. Hello, everyone. And welcome to Music Today. Yeah. How's it going, third grade? It's great to see you. Thanks for tuning in to today's music class. Let's take a look at what I have in store for you today. Checking out the schedule, starting off always with hello and warm up. We're going to do Spring's Message, which we started last time, as well as I'm Hungry. Ooh, that's already making me hungry. A new song this week called Little Liza Jane, and then our Musician of the Month, and then we say goodbye. Now let's take a look at our goals for today's class. Now within Spring's Message, we're going to identify some different rhythms in the song and kind of pay attention to the pattern of the sounds of the words. With our I'm Hungry, I've got a new B section that I want to create today. We'll get a little silly with that song. And then with our new song, Liza Jane, kind of listening for differences in melody as we learn the song. But before we do anything, it is time to warm it up. And I just want to do a quick warm-up today with one of my favorite vocal warm-ups from Chorus. And that is Dwee-a-Babaloo. Sounds like this. Dwee-a-Babaloo, 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 Babaloo, Dwee. Dwee-a-Babaloo, 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 Babaloo, Dwee. It's a bit of a tongue twister. For those of you who don't know it, it starts off like this. Dwee-a-Babaloo. Say that. Dwee-a-Babaloo. And you're going to say that three times in a row, like this. Dwee-a-Babaloo, Dwee-a-Babaloo, Dwee-a-Babaloo. Ready, go. Dwee-a-Babaloo, Dwee-a-Babaloo, Dwee-a-Babaloo. Now, the fourth time, you're going to say it, but you're going to flip the parts around, and you're going to say, Babaloo, Dwee. Babaloo, Dwee. So it goes like this. Dwee-a-Babaloo, 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 Babaloo, Dwee. Just like that. And when you sing it, it sounds like this. Sing with me if you know it. Dwee-a-Babaloo, 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 Babaloo, Dwee. Dwee-a-Babaloo, 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 Babaloo, Dwee. Just like that. Great work, great work, great work. So now let's sing it a little higher. Dwee-a-Babaloo, 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 Babaloo, Dwee. Dwee-a-Babaloo, 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 Babaloo. Dwee-a-Babaloo, 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 Babaloo, Dwee. 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 Dwee-a-Babaloo, Dwee-a-Babaloo, Dwee.
Nice job. Could you keep up? Could you sing it as fast as me? If not, keep trying. It's a real fun way to do. All right. Well, why wait? Let's dive into today's class. And this is our Spring's Message song that we started last time. And if you don't remember, it goes like this. And if you do remember, try singing along. Cuckoo, cuckoo calls from the tree. Now let us sing and dance and be merry. Coo, 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 coo calls from the tree. calls from the tree. Come to the field, so pleasant to see, for springtime comes verily.
Let's do a little echo singing right now, since we're warmed up from our Dwee Ababaloos. Repeat after me, my turn first. Cuckoo, 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 calls from the tree, calls from the tree. Now let us sing, now let us sing, and dance and be merry, and dance and be merry. Coo, 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 calls from the tree, calls from the tree. Let's try just the first verse together. If you're still learning it, you can go ahead and listen this time, but if you're ready to sing with me, go ahead and sing it with me. First verse, what we just learned.
Cuckoo, cuckoo, calls from the tree. Now let us sing and dance and be merry. Cuckoo, cuckoo, calls from the tree.
Nice job, nice job, nice job. Let's take a look at the second verse now. Starts the same.
Cuckoo, cuckoo, calls from the tree.
Your turn.
Cuckoo, cuckoo, calls from the tree.
My turn.
Come to the fields, come to the fields, so pleasant to see, so pleasant to see, for springtime, springtime, for springtime, springtime, comes merrily, comes merrily.
Let's sing the whole second verse together now. Nice job, nice job, nice job. Now, I want to go back up to the first verse, and I want you to listen as I sing, and I want you to listen for the difference between the first time I sing the cuckoos and the second time I see the cuckoos, and maybe if you can see what the difference is.
Cuckoo, cuckoo, calls from the tree. Now let us sing and dance and be merry. Cuckoo, cuckoo, calls from the tree.
Did you notice that there was something different between the way I sang cuckoo, cuckoo the first time and cuckoo, cuckoo the second time? Well, let's take a look at actually some rhythms and maybe we can figure out what precisely is the difference. So I've got two rhythms written up here on the board. I've got rhythm A and rhythm B. And let's start with rhythm A. It's a pretty simple rhythm. It's got three beats, two tas, and a rest. And it sounds like this. Ta, ta, rest. Ready, here you go. Ta, ta, rest. And if you put it on a loop, it sounds like this. Ta, 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 rest. Ta, ta, rest. Ta, ta. If you've got some sort of a found sound instrument at your disposal, you can play it on your instrument. And why don't you play that rhythm while I sing the first verse and see if it matches up with one of our cuckoos, okay? So let's play the rhythm. It's ta-ta, rest together. Ta-ta. And you can just keep playing while I sing.
Cuckoo, cuckoo, calls from the tree. Now let us sing and dance and be merry. Cuckoo, cuckoo, calls from the tree.
Nice work. Let's look at that other rhythm up there. I see a two and a ta. Again, a two is worth two beats and a ta is worth one. So it's another three beat pattern. And we would say two, ta, two, ta. Can you play this on your instrument? Just like that. And I'm going to play that while I sing the first verse again. Would you play with me? Two, ta, two, ta.
Cuckoo, cuckoo, calls from the tree. Now let us sing and dance and be merry. Nice job. Now, looking back at this rhythm, we need to figure out which rhythm matches which part of the song. So if we have part A, rhythm A up here, and we go ta, ta, rest, and we change that to cuckoo, we have cuckoo, cuckoo. Try that with me. Ready, go. Cuckoo, cuckoo. And if we have part B up here, ta, two, ta, two, ta, and we change that to cuckoo, we have cuckoo, cuckoo. These are starting to sound familiar. The first rhythm, rhythm A, goes at the beginning of the song. Cuckoo, cuckoo, ta, 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 ta. The second rhythm, rhythm B, goes at the end of the song, or end of the verse. Cuckoo, cuckoo, two, ta, two, ta. Just like that. So even though we have the same words, they can sound different because we're using different rhythms. Nice job with that. Nice job with that. Well, I'm starting to get a little bit hungry. Maybe you are too. I'm hungry, I'm hungry. I need something to munch. I'm dreaming of the sandwich that I brought for lunch. I'm hungry, I'm hungry. I need something to munch. I'm dreaming of the sandwich that I brought for lunch. And last week we created a B section with some different ingredients and a different sandwich. And we made a very healthy sandwich last week. We had cheese, romaine lettuce sliced, turkey, fancy mustard cheese. Romaine lettuce sliced, turkey, fancy mustard. And then we went back to sing the song again. I'm hungry, I'm hungry. I need something to munch. I'm dreaming of the sandwich that I brought for lunch. I'm hungry, I'm hungry. I need something to munch. I'm dreaming of the sandwich that I brought for lunch. Now, one of the things that I like to do when I'm in school with you all and doing this in class is I like to have students pick some silly ingredients to make our sandwich. And what I'd like you to do at home is be thinking of your own silly ingredients you could put on the sandwich. You need four of them, and put together a little chant that you could say in the middle here. But I thought, in absence of being able to do it together, I'd at least give you my suggestion for some silly ingredients. So here's the sandwich that I've been dreaming about for lunch. It goes like this. Chocolate bar, cotton candy, buffalo wings, fish. And I'm only now realizing I've misspelled the word chocolate. Should be chocolate. Oh, that's not it. There we go. Aha, okay. Whew. All this time away from school, I'm starting to forget how to spell. Chocolate bar, cotton candy, buffalo wings, fish. Can we say, repeat after me. Chocolate bar, cotton candy, buffalo wings, fish. Fish. All right. Let's sing the song, and then we're going to do this ingredients for a sandwich for our B section. And then we'll do it again, and maybe you can have your own ingredients. I'm hungry, I'm hungry. I need something to munch. I'm dreaming of a sandwich that I brought for lunch. I'm hungry, I'm hungry. I need something to munch. I'm dreaming of a sandwich that I brought for lunch. Here we go now. Chocolate bar, cotton candy, buffalo wings, fish. 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 I'm hungry, I'm hungry. I need something to munch. I'm dreaming of a sandwich that I brought for lunch. All right, so here's what I'd like you to do. Let's create our own sandwich. And what I need you to do right now is maybe you need to write this down on a piece of paper, or you can think of it in your mind, but I want you to pause the video and take a few moments to think of four ingredients to sing in our song, just like I did with my silly ingredients, okay? Pause the video, come up with your four ingredients, and then unpause. I'll wait. Do, 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 do. Do, 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 do. And welcome back! Ha! Wow, I didn't even know you were gone. So, you've got your four ingredients. And what I'm going to do is when I get to the middle section where the ingredients, we're going to say the ingredients, I'm just going to count 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. And I want you to say an ingredient each time I count, all right? So, you've got your list of four ingredients. We're going to sing together and then chant your ingredients together. I'm hungry, I'm hungry, I need something to munch. I'm dreaming of the sandwich that I brought for lunch. Here we go, and 1, 2, 3, 4. Do it again now. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Last time now. 1, 2, 3, 4. Here we go. I'm hungry, I'm hungry, I need something to munch. I'm dreaming of the sandwich that I brought for lunch. Woo, woo wee, woo wee. I don't know about you, but I really am hungry now. Oh boy. Alright, well let's move on to one final song today before we get to our musician of the month. And this song is an old classic called Little Liza Jane. And as I sing it for you, I want you to listen for some parts that are repeated over and over. So, here's part one. Goes,
I got a house in Baltimore, Little Liza Jane. Streetcar runs right by my door, Little Liza Jane. Oh, Eliza, Little Liza Jane. Eliza, Little Liza Jane.
That's part one. Here's verse two.
Come, my friend, and be with me, Little Liza Jane. I will take good care of thee, Little Liza Jane. Oh, Eliza, Little Liza Jane. Oh, Eliza, Little Liza Jane.
Alright, alright, alright. Let's go back to the first verse up here. Now, did you notice that there's some parts and some phrases that are repeated over and over and over again? Yeah. So, one of the things that's sort of repeated over and over throughout the song is Little Liza Jane. It's sort of the period, the end, the bookend to each line of the song. And we also have the Oh Eliza part, which comes up a couple of times. Now, I want you to listen very carefully as I sing this first part to you again. And notice, when I sing Little Liza Jane, do I sing it the same way each time, or is it a little different each time I sing it? And if it is different, how is it different?
I got a house in Baltimore, Little Liza Jane. Streetcar runs right by my door, Little Liza Jane. Oh, Eliza, Little Liza Jane. Oh, Eliza, Little Liza Jane.
Notice it? Listen one more time and listen for the direction of the melody, the direction of my voice. When I sing, does my voice always go up? Does it always go down? Or does it change each time? All right.
I got a house in Baltimore, Little Liza Jane. When I trip right by my door, Little Liza Jane. Oh, Eliza, Little Liza Jane.
All right. Well, you might notice that they're in different colors up there. That's on purpose. You notice we've got some like gold-looking Little Liza Janes, kind of yellowish, goldish. When we sing those, it sounds like this:
Little Liza Jane.
It's a little high in our voice, but I want you to try with it. Ready?
Little Liza Jane.
And when you see the ones that are sort of pink, you're gonna sing Little Liza Jane. Just like that. And you'll notice that the first Little Liza Jane, the golden Little Liza Janes, they start high, they go low, and then they sort of end high. So they go, boop, just like that.
Little Liza Jane.
And then the second ones, the pink ones, they go, Little Liza Jane. Kind of start in the middle, and they go down, and they end low. They end low like that. So if you can remember that, I'm going to put you in charge of the Little Liza Janes. And I'm going to sing the other part. I'm going to sing the words that are in white. Okay? So you're in charge of the Little Liza Janes. I'm in charge of the words in white.
I got a house in Baltimore. Streetcar runs right by my door. Oh, Eliza. Oh, Eliza.
Not bad. Let's try the second verse now. Same job.
Come, my friend, and be with me. I will take good care of thee. Oh, Eliza, little. Oh, Eliza.
Nice job singing with me. Great work. We'll spend some more time with that song next week, but I really want to get to something awesome for you right now. Let's talk, finally, for the last time this month, about our Musician of the Month. And our Musician of the Month for the month of May, as you guys all know, is Freddie Mercury. Freddie Mercury, the lead singer of the band Queen. And their most famous song, and by far one of the greatest rock songs ever created, is Bohemian Rhapsody. It's a song that not only features rock guitars and drums and amazing singing, it also features soulful piano, operatic singing, and dramatic storytelling that really didn't exist in rock music at this time. It was also really long for a rock and roll song. Most of the times, these songs are about 2 to 3 minutes. They're kind of quick, they're snappy, you can listen to them on the radio and get on to another one. But this one was actually about 7 minutes long. And a lot of people thought, this song isn't going to work, it's too long, it's too weird. And yet it's one of the songs that we remember most from the band Queen. And this song has been featured in TV shows, movies, and all across media, and there's been tributes by lots of different artists. So I thought I'd share one of my favorite versions of Bohemian Rhapsody, and that is a version by our friend, The Muppets. Enjoy.
Is this the real life? Is this just fantasy? Caught in a landslide, no escape from reality. Open your eyes, look up to the skies and see. I'm just a poor boy, I need no sympathy. 'Cause I'm easy come, easy go, little high, little low. Any way the wind blows doesn't really matter to me. To me. Mama. Mama? Yeah. Mama.
Nobody loves me.
He's just a poor boy from a poor family, spared in his life from this
monstrosity. No, no, no.
Easy come, easy go. Will you let me go?
Ma, ma, ma,
let me throw.
Ma, na, ma, na.
They will not let you throw.
Let me blow.
Ma, na, ma, na.
They will not let you blow.
Let me jump.
Do not like your jokes.
Let me jump.
Do not like your jokes.
Let me jump.
No, 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 no!
Vernigini, Vernigini!
Mamma mia, let me go!
can see, nothing really matters. Nothing really matters. But moi!
Scooter?
Yeah, Chief?
Remind me to stop setting up these video conferences. They're not very productive.
You got it.
Sheesh.
All right. I don't know. Does your classroom meeting sometimes feel a little bit like that? All right. So, had a lot of fun and a lot of great memories of listening to and learning about Freddie Mercury and Queen this month for our May Musician of the Month. But unfortunately, it's that time again. So, until next week, third graders, goodbye.
Goodbye, third grade. Goodbye, third grade. Goodbye, third grade.